Hey everyone, welcome back to my Lego room where I've got just a small update today where I want to show you what I've done to the wall of collectible minifigures as I've put up the Batman movie one, finally, including the Batwing in there. Let's take a closer look at that. Yep, only the official Lego collectible minifigures go on this wall for this particular display. I think it looks pretty good. Adds some life to this room. And here are the Lego Batman movie ones that are on a different display. So all the others I tried to be pretty consistent with in how I set them up. I mean, some of the series required a little bit of extra space where they had more figures than normal, but you know, most of these look the same and have exactly the same spacing, and they're just very straightforward. But with this Lego Batman movie one, when I was doing my review of the poly bag for the Batwing itself, I realized that I wanted to use that in this display, just actually during the video itself, during the recording of it. So I stuck with that, and I like it. You know, changes things up a little bit. Had to put all of these really close together, you know, actually touching one to the next, but everything works. You know, some of these had to be spaced forward just a little bit in order to get enough space on the back, like for the wings here and the inflatable duck tube for that one, and also the skirt for this one here. But yeah, I think they look nice, and this has actually encouraged me to think about trying some other things for some of my other series if I want to. I mean, eventually I'm going to run out of space here. I have enough space between these to reduce these horizontal spaces to actually bring in a whole other column of these plates that I'm using. And I did a separate video explaining how all of this works. I'll go ahead and carefully try to pull this off to show you what's going on behind there. If you haven't seen that video, or just as a teaser to it, this has Neo magnets on the back, partial rare earth magnets on the back. And this is a magnetic whiteboard. And this all just works out well. These are strictly bricks plates, you know, actual plates, not base plates. But it works pretty well and allows me to reposition things when I want. And it's tough to do with just one hand, but I'm making it work, man. I'm making it work. Yeah, so that's the first time that I've actually added to this wall in a little while. I think actually since my reveal of the full wall itself. So I wanted to be sure to show that. I'll be probably bringing in some other magnetic things over time, and like I said, trying some different stuff with some of these as appropriate. You know, change up some shapes, change up some spacing, maybe add in some more, you know, things relevant to the series as they make sense, or maybe make one of the characters in each kind of the star of the thing. You know, might be a cool thing to do. But there we go. On a only mildly related note, also this week I have added back in one of these shorter shelving units down below, which previously was in the studio. I put a full height one in the studio and brought one of these small ones back here to give myself a lot more space. This is all very messy right now because a lot of things are in kind of a transition state as some things get moved around and some things get ready to be moved out. I was also doing a build over there because my normal building space is pretty crowded right now. So yeah, just a lot of little stuff going on that happens behind the scenes. That's it for this video. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed looking at that, and I'll be talking to you again soon.